Well, I hope they do something. Remember that child that fell off the deck last year?
Yeah, that was bad. I'm sure they'll do something.
Shit! What the fuck? Just walking around like a badass, huh? Alright. Well, hello everyone, welcome back to Little Viking Studios. My name is Mr. Gloves, and I'm continuing with Fallout 3. And, nope. Because I'm pretty sure I have enough caps. I don't really care about you. I think I have enough caps to get a room. Seeing as I don't really have anywhere else that has a bed. Oh, okay. Sorry about that. I just thought it was funny. My bad. It's not like it was yours, prick. But I need to sleep somewhere because I don't really feel like using the stimpaks I just bought. You know, days ago when I last recorded this. This one. Hello, Mr. Robot.
Welcome to the Weatherly. Mr. Buckingham at your service.
Hello, Mr. Buckingham. Who's your owner? Not Rust Bucket. What is this place? How much for a room?
Oh, the mere 120 caps.
Sounds like a fair price. I'll take it.
Excellent. Simply venture into the hallway, turn left, first door on your left. That is your room.
Is that the broom closet? I always get those two mixed up.
I'm going to have to cut my voice out on that one because I didn't hear what he said. So we're going to find out later during editing. At least I'm going to. And I might, you know, caption it. Who knows? Well, you'll know because you would have already seen it. What is this place? What do you have to eat? That's all for now.
Yes, ma'am.
I was kind of hoping that you'd say something else kind of rude. Hello.
Welcome back, ma'am.
Hello, pretty lady. I already got a room. So what's the story with Dr. Lee? What's the deal with the little punk, James Hargrave?
Poor James. His mother drinks too much. When she doesn't treat him very well. Personally, I think she blames him for his father leaving her, which is ridiculous.
Bit. What's it like living on a giant ship? What do you have to eat? So long, Vera.
Farewell.
Farewell. I probably have to go back to that kid. I never even finished the those mission, did I? Wait a minute. If I can get in here, I'm gonna get in here, and I'm gonna take whatever the fuck I want. Smash. Got your... You just have that on a shelf, just because. Yes. Let's use key. Mine. Nope. Okay. What else does asshole have? So... The way this looks, it's like a speech recognizer that types it up. Alright. I don't know if those ever existed ever. But if they did, that's pretty cool. Boom, boom, and nothing. Cool. I was never in there. You didn't see that. Stay out of my hotel room, by the way. I don't want anybody coming in here. Now that includes you, unless I ask you to. Please come into my hotel room. Aww. Ah! Alright, fine, you can come to my hotel room. Come on, baby! This bed's good enough for two! Yeah, No one loves me! Alright, enough fucking around. What's in here? Oh, that's right! Yeah, this is my room now, so I guess I can put whatever I want anywhere. Which includes my naughty nightwear and power armor and helmet. I'm not even wearing that. Nope, I'm not wearing a damn thing. That's fine, whatever. I'm sexy. Look at me. Yeah. Sexy Asian lady. Yeah. Anyway. Sexy Asian lady with very little health. That's a definite. Alright. I'll never get the controls of any of the games I'm playing right. You are now well rested. Good. I'm glad. Actually, is there anything else I can dump off while I'm here? What's this? This is like the cleanest looking table in all of the Wasteland. You gotta admit, it really is. Like, look at that. Look at that. Look at that fine craftsmanship. Alright. Anything I can get rid of? Never really gonna get rid of any weapons. I got 9 stealth boys. Holy shit. That's pretty good. Wow. It really isn't much. Oh, actually. Yeah, those don't even have any weight. None of this has any weight. So why the fuck do I care about any of that? I really don't have anything that I need to get rid of. I just have a bunch of shit in my inventory. I mean, once I get my repair up enough, I can get rid of a whole... Actually, yeah, hold on. Let's go back to aid. Blood packs can all go in there because I'm saving those for the vampire people. Whatever the fuck, I don't care. Damage resistance? Yeah, it's nice to have on hand. Well, they don't even have weight. I'm only looking for stuff with weight. Put both those in there. There's a bunch of... I'm pretty sure I have a bunch of Nuka-Cola Quantums over at GNR. So... those do have weight, so... I should probably only have, like, 3 of them on me at any given time. Yeah, just keep them out of my inventory. And I should probably only have about 3 of these on me at any given... Oh, shit. I really should only have 2 of those on me at any given time. I'm spitting a lot. Alright. Well, that takes care of that. Ba-ding! Better not... I better have that room forever. Sorry, you didn't pay your rent, so we gave your room away. What about all my shit? Well, it comes with the room. Fuck you! Oh, man, that would suck. Hey, baby! It is nice to see you, too. I love your hair. I think the best haircut in the world is a pixie haircut. I just love short hair. And fucking, like I said, every motherfucking woman in all of Fallout has fucking short hair, and I'm loving it. And again, I'm pretty sure I said this is like in the first few episodes. If that's what it takes, yeah, it's when I first got to the Megaton. Because I ran into Nova, who I'm going to have to kill. Losers. And, Hold on. I hit you in the head with a bucket. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Here you go, buddy.
Please, water. Help me.
Bloop! Dead bodies. How about dead bodies? Would you like a dead body? I have dead bodies. There you go, buddy. Have a dead body. Oh, still thirsty? Well, how about some dead bodies? Don't you look happy? And now, look up the grass.
Please, I'm dying. I need water.
Yeah, and we're all tired of looking at you, so you know what? Just do me a favor. Put this on your head. Put it on your head. Carlos! 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 Fine. What a jerk. What a jerk. Anyway, what was this? Boys and girls, we've got ourselves another holier-than-thou right knight needs putting down. Here are the deals. Name, Cherry Papa Susky. Race, Asian, sex, female. The bounty is 1,000 caps this time around. And for a change of pace, they want the head this time. Good hunting. So, at first, I was being hunted down because I'm a holier-than-thou white knight. But then, this indispensable guy... Oh, no, that's the wrong thing. Bounty notice. Alright, notice all regulators. Let it be known that the following individual is offered for blah, 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 blah. Crimes against the good people of the Capital Wasteland and environs. Which is a word I had a lot of trouble with. I don't need to sell anything. Where am I going? That's right, I'm going to GNR. GNR. GNR, GNR, GNR. That's like... Right there. There. I'm gonna get my stuff back from the GNR building, get it put in my room over at, Rivet City.
I'm moving out of Megaton,
even though I hadn't technically moved in yet. I'm glad all the bodies stay. That's the one good thing. Like, they leave the bodies so if you ever need to, you can go back and get the shit that you left behind. It's a good system for the game. And you know, I'm glad these guys don't have... Well, they did it once, why couldn't they do it again? Like, seriously, what is different from before? Anyway. Oh yeah, I have to be hidden while I do it. Alright. Take all the new color quantums, take that, take all those... And still not even encumbered. That's impressive. I remember I almost put it over there or something, but... Just making sure. Alright. So, go to Rivet City, put all that back in my room. Which I'm gonna have to find a faster way to get to than having to go through the marketplace. But, that's... I was already in here. You can't welcome me when I've already gone right past you. And why is... Alright, never mind. I was gonna reflect on that. Nah, I don't have enough time. Yeah, I definitely don't have enough time. Just ignore all that. Just ignore everything I was just saying. It'll come up in a different episode for probably a different series when I have more time to edit that stuff in. So... Okay, for a second there, I thought I just fast traveled from Rivet City to Rivet City, but nope, I'm just losing track of what I've been doing. Because I'm a big old moron whose tongue hurts because he ate too salty of popcorn. I'm gonna play this game like Miley Cyrus.
Hey guys, let's play this video right here. And I went the wrong way to get to my room. I should have gone to school well. But then again, this is the way I know. Maybe I kind of climb my room the other way.
I can't stick my tongue out as far as she can. Probably a good thing. No, actually, it's probably a bad thing. If I ever want a girlfriend who's gonna stay around, probably a bad thing that my tongue doesn't go that far out. What a shame. No, I'm just getting to practice. Ah! Why, you in my room? Get the fuck out of my room. This is my room. Jackass. What the fuck was on my hand? Alright. I can repair all... I should have been able to repair all those when I... Nah, no, I don't even care. I'm pretty sure I was encumbered and I just wanted to get the fuck out of there. So, who the fuck cares? What am I looking for? What did I grab? New Cola Quantums. Boop, 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 boop. Wait. Okay. For a second, I was like, I know I had other Nuka-Cola Quantums there. But... Sir, stop talking like you're right in my fucking room, because it keeps scaring the fucking shit out of me, bro. Close. Close. Okay. Sir!
Any trouble in this area?
Doesn't look it, boss! Fucking moron. Who are you? Oh, darkness. Why are you eating? We... Well, at least I know. Your eyes are weird. Look at those eyes! Did you see his eyes? They were creepy! Oh, wait. Crap.
I am Father Clifford of St. Monica's Church.
I saw his face and I was like, oh, you're the historical guy, but no.
She is the patron saint of lost children. Very popular among the faithful of Rivet City. I'm surprised you've never heard of her. If
really?
If you want to hear her story, it will be the topic of my sermon on Sunday. Services begin at 8 a.m. You should come.
No, thank you. I'd like to make it... No! No. I need to go, Father Clifford.
Saint Monica bless you.
Go fuck yourself. That's what we say where I'm from. What are you doing?
Hey.
Hi. Right. See, I bet I can get a lot of cool stuff. I systematically killed everyone in Rivet City. Which, who knows? Maybe one day I will. But right now, we're just working on Megaton. Are you the bitch? No, I don't care.
Yeah?
Are you related to Henry Young?
Henry's my husband. I have a daughter, CJ, too. You'll see her running around here with James Hargrave.
She's walking right behind you. Why do you let that James Hargrave kid play with your daughter?
That poor child. His mother,
oh, Hargrave, right. He's a kid, too.
A very troubled woman. She spends too much time down in the Muddy Rudder, drinking and using foul language. I feel so sorry for him. I think CJ is a good influence on him, but I do worry about the two of them.
Yeah, the drinking part on that one. That's bad, but, foul language? I mean, my parents actually actively tried not to use foul language around me when I was a kid, and fuck, how the fuck did I fucking turn out with the dick, punch, cunt, fuck, twat, motherfucker? Blah, blah, blah. Pitch it, fuck, cunt, talk, some of the tits. Shit, piss, cunt, fuck, cocks of the motherfucker tits. Don't worry, I know what it is. I know actually how to say it. I just stumble over myself because I'm a dumbass. And I'm a little drunk. But, no, I'm not. Actually, I've been drinking. I haven't had a... That's the last time I got drunk. Well, shit. Now I kind of have to. Who knows, people, you might be seeing a new Drink Theft Auto in a little bit, like, you know, a few days, maybe, I don't know, I have some beer in the fridge, I could. It's my night off. But I want to go see a movie tonight. I gotta get back to- Game! What do you people do here all day? Thank you for your help, Chrissy. Yeah, I don't care.
Goodbye.
I don't care what the fuck you do here.
Everything is
falling. Hi, CJ.
I'm the only one willing to fix it.
Yes, miss. Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
I'm busy. I've got a lot of repairs to make.
Oh. You're a fun bunch. Ah! What's this? Oh, it's a time waster. I'm terrible. 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 I'm terrible. I'm terrible at what I do. I don't have a focused goal at the moment. I also have my, like, the three top buttons of my shirt are unbuttoned. Luckily, let's see, yeah, let's see, it's out of shot. Okay. Luckily. But, I need a focused goal. I need to go do something. I need to hit the right buttons and not think I'm playing fucking Grand Theft Auto or Tomb Raider or Banjo-Kazooie Or Fallout 3. No, you were playing Fallout 3! Stop confusing me! Why are you suddenly being so fucking annoying with the fucking meowing in my fucking videos? Investigate Marigold Metro Station and remove the source of the fire. It's right. 10 minutes. Look for data on Project Purity. Disarm Megatons. No. Continue to search for clues in your identity. Alright, fine. I would like to. There we go. Springvale Megaton, Vault 101. Big Town. Blah, 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 blah. Where the fuck is it? Super Duper Mart. Megaton. What the hell? Great Itch. Marigold Station. Alright. I got. Alright, good. Oh, good. It's already turned to those. Did I just land? Nice! A quarter just fell off my page and it landed in my quarter bucket. It didn't even land in the diamond nickels bucket. It landed in my quarter bucket.
Scary nighttime, no likey.
Also, can't fucking see. And also gives me a good opportunity to flip to the page I need to plodge to. Is what you get. Well, ah!
If it isn't the little villain from the vault, we've been looking for you. Someone's put quite a price on your head. What? You think you can walk around the wasteland doing the evil that you do, and there isn't going to be someone who takes notice? And now it's time for you to die.
Okay.
Ha! I love it when they go down fighting.
Okay. I am wearing armor, right? Okay. Combat shotgun. How many do I have? 4. Alrighty then. Alrighty then. That's 22. The Chinese. Alright, still 29. Okay.
Finally, got you in my sights.
Okay, good for you. Take him out, 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 kill him, 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 kill him. Just kill him! This is bullshit, this is bullshit, this is bullshit, this is bullshit! Oh my god. No, 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 I can actually survive this. I can survive this. I can actually live. I just need to find a good place to fucking hide. Oh my god. Go, go, go. Alright, go, go, go. Jump, jump, jump. Alright. Okay. Now they're gonna have to come down. Alright, cool. Okay. Hold on. Reload, reload, reload. Okay, nope, I guess I don't have to. Okay. Stimpak, Stimpak, Stimpak! Okay. Okay. Watch the health. Oh, crap. Watch the health, watch the health. Okay, still good on the health. Still good on the health. Yep, got one, got one. Still good on the health. Still just gonna do that just in case they, like, overload me with bullets. Alright, we got one shot on you. You're almost dead. Oh, you are dead. Alright. And then we quick lock onto you and... Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap.
I am champion!
I can't even end the episode on that. That would have been perfect. Holy crap. That was great. Oh, now I got shotgun shells. All right. Holy shit. Was that a fight or was that a fight? I'm all energized and shit, man. Fuck. That scared the fucking shit out of me. Holy crap. Man. Woo! Butchering the. Alright, I haven't even made it near there yet. That's actually a good sign. Alright, intermission. Okay. Intermission over, but only for so long, because because last time I took the less dangerous path that took me to Grady's whatever, which I would have ended up at anyway, but we didn't take this path. I hope this is the right path. Yep, to the east. Alright, so we didn't take this one. Although I did kill the ant that was here, and I'm not sure how many more there are. Alright, there's one more. And he's gonna blow fire! This is not a turn. Alright, I was gonna say, this is not a turn-based game, alright? You don't have to wait for him to attack me back. Oh, crap! I didn't see the second one! Crap. But yeah. Cherry, you don't have to wait for the fire ants to attack you before you get to attack them again. You can just shoot the fuck out of them. And it'll be perfectly acceptable. Here comes another blast. I really don't want to waste all that ammo. How many do I have in the hunting rifle? Oh, plenty. I say now. As long as I'm careful with the shots, I should be okay. Why didn't that take any health? Wow, you move fast, all of a sudden. There. Okay. Oh, what do you know? See, I actually never looked. I guess when you're still on fire, it does take one little bar of damage as you continue to be on fire, but yeah, it's really nothing, to be honest. Alright. So, turn the corner, we took care of the... Alright, hold on. Light, camera, action. Nope. Okay. It's good to sell. May as well get something out of this, right? I don't see any red dots, so I feel good. Plus, I think I made it at least into that door to the right, to my right, so. Awesome, I can still carry 100 pounds more of shit. Man, that power armor takes up so much fucking inventory space. Open lawnmower! Yeah, you don't really find too many of those, so I'm gonna take them while I can. Because I don't remember what I use them for, but... probably gonna take me forever to find them again. All of them. I don't care. I'll take all three. See if I give a shit. Okay. Get some railway spikes. And that looks like it's about it. Alright, cool. Wait, what was that? Oh, never mind. Just some textures. Okay. Intermission. Okay, let me see if I can't figure out what the box. I mean, what the book is telling me about. Yeah, follow the blue line trail, right? Till we get down here, and we have the fight with the fire ants, which I already had. And then it said to search this alcove, right? And then search the corpse has the ammo for, all right, so there should have been a corpse here, right? Probably. Wait, I didn't check that. Oh. For shame on me! No one even told me. Boop! There we go. At least it said there was a corpse. Corpse? 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 Corpse, 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 corpse. Wait, huh? What do you have? Alright. I don't see no corpses. Oh, this corpse? 44 man. Oh, yeah, that did have stuff. Alright, cool. We are on the right path. Alright. Yep, so you get the 44 and the magnums. Yeah, because magnums are hard to come by. That's good. That's awesome. Alright. There's also a sledgehammer, a sonic 10mm pistol to grab, which I must have already grabbed. You can head south to check out the maintenance corridor door, or continue east. The tunnel bridge is to the right. If you continue east, you end up in Falls Church Metro Station and away from this quest. If you take the branching path to the right, you can locate Grady's chamber, but you need another key first. Ignore this area for the moment. Right. So what? Intermission. Okay, intermission over. It says that if I want to get every valuable item, I should go down this way, and that one of these rooms has a gas chamber with a really evil, mean fire ant, which I may have already killed, because clearly I've already gone down this way at some point. I'm just not sure how far I made it. But its suggestion, which I'm totally going to take up on if I haven't already, you know, nearly killed myself by doing this, to begin with. Where is it? Use one of these. Because in that gas room, if the fire ant breathes fire, or if you shoot, big boom. So, in theory, there should be a gas leak down here. If I do this, oh crap, I'm gonna end up right in the explosion. Unless this isn't that room, or I've already set off the explosion. Wah! That made such a creepy fucking sound! Ooh, I saw fire. Maybe the gas went off. That'd be nice. Wouldn't that be nice? Yeah, it probably didn't happen, though. Alright, I was gonna say, are we really gonna have this fight of trying to find your fucking head again? Come on. Just... Alright. Cool. Is that it? Sweet. Can't meet. Alright. So I'm gonna guess that when I did come down here, I was pretty much out of health. And didn't want to go anywhere near the fucking ant and die. Also, I found that other exit, so, you know. Moved on from there and completely abandoned this quest for a while. And now I have no idea how long I've been going. Guys, I have no idea how long those intermissions were. I did not check. Alright, but... either way, I'll try to find what I'm actually down here looking for, and then I'll end the episode, so. Unfortunately, I couldn't end it with that awesome destruction of fucking bounty hunter assholes. But, you know, you win some, you lose some, right? Well, in my case, you win a couple, you lose most. If not all. Alright. Check every metal box. I hate the fucking, the chips that are taken out of the top of the table, because I always think they're fucking caps. Because oftentimes they will be caps. Oftentimes they leave caps just lying on tables. But you never know. But jeez, how far does this go? Where the hell am I now? Oh. No way, did I make it down to Lesko's or something? Intermission. Hold on! We missed something. I missed something. Fucking... Yes, yeah, not... Alright, the room that I was referring to with the gas and everything... Yeah, it was one room back. At least I think so. That seems to be what it's saying. And... There's a door! There's a door with Grady's safe key! That's how we get into the Grady's fucking shit room. That's how we get his treasure! I'm an idiot! I totally overlooked this! I'm gonna check this room again, because I think they said that there's something else. I don't need the pack of cigarettes. I want that psycho, and I want that stim pack. What the fuck was that? Hello? That. What the fuck? Okay. I'm just gonna ignore that. And try not to be terrified that someone's gonna come up and stab me. Shit, okay. I wonder if that came up. It probably didn't. I'm probably just hearing things or something, but damn! It scared the shit out of me. Alright. Don't think. Ah, there's a gun cabinet or a tool cabinet. That's a crap. Man, I totally overlooked this room. Don't do weird music like that, you bastards. Sons of bitches. Jerks? Okay. But anyway, yeah, I guess back to finding out where the fuck I'm going. Intermission! Okay, I know where we're going. We're gonna... Alright, so this path does actually lead us to both Grady's... Grady's locker, whatever the fuck Grady hid wherever. And it leads us to the doctor that I'm looking for. That's the doctor, right? Yeah. But if we keep going this way, that looks weird. And I'm gonna keep a lookout for mines, just even though it didn't say anything about mines. I really don't want to run over any mines, because that would suck. And then we're gonna go this way. And I'm pretty sure that... Where the hell did you come from? Oh, were you with the guy who... Oh, that's where your body went. I was wondering that. I knew the ants had killed you, but I didn't know what the hell they did with your body. Alright, well, questions answered, I guess. I'm pretty sure all the ants that I had to deal with around here are dead. I'm pretty sure I killed them in that room, in Grady's room. Plunger. Okay. And then... Yeah, it should be to the right, and yeah, marked by the spinning light. Can't miss it. So I was right. This is Grady's thing. I just didn't know what the fuck I was looking for to open. Grady's safe, which I apparently already opened. Are you fucking serious? Are you fucking... There's no secret, like... Nope, that was it. That was... Alright. Well... Fuck... Me. I thought that was one of the few that you actually had to have a key for. The lockers over at, Flak and Trapinal's gun store at Rivet City. Those ones, it doesn't even matter if you have 100 lockpicking skill. You have to have the key. I thought Grady's thing was like that. I'm an idiot.
You startled me.
You startled me.
You mustn't creep up on people like that.
Neither should you. Hey, you're that egghead. I mean, scientist the kid was talking about. Sorry, I didn't expect to bump into anyone alive down here.
That is precisely why this is the ideal place for my work. Do you realize you're trampling about in a delicately balanced and highly sensitive experimentation area?
Now, which Pokemon would you like first? He sounds like fucking Professor Oak. Well, a much nerdier Professor Oak. And this is my grandson. Oh, what's his name again? Fucking fool. Experiments? Experiments? What do you mean? You call us a laboratory. How about we start the experiment by decorating that wall with your brains? No. Experiments? What do you mean?
My experiments are of a complex nature and would take a scientist to explain. Oh, wait. I'm a scientist. How marvelous. My foray into reducing the girth of these insectoid creatures is of utmost importance. I intend to generationally reduce their immense stature by way of a pre-birth induced mutagen. Isn't that clever?
Alright, I'm gonna use intelligence and science. Oh, I see. You're trying to make them smaller over time by injecting the eggs. Because if you have any, if you don't have enough intelligence, you're just gonna be like, what? Or you, or yeah. Okay, how about explaining this that for slow for the slower people? Okay, enough with the mumbo jumbo. Slow down, Professor. Once more in English, okay? Can we skip the story and get to a solution? Intelligence.
My word, you understand perfectly. How marvelous!
Marvelous. So, what's gone wrong? Are you aware your new ants breathe fire? I've got news for you, Brainiac. It ain't working. Can we skip the story and get... Alright, I'm gonna say, are you aware that your new ants breathe fire?
Well, this is rather embarrassing, so you'll have to forgive me, but it appears that I've made a slight miscalculation in my mutagen samples.
Really?
Instead of lowering the size of the ants, the brood hatched and developed a new biomechanism. I call their genetic aberration pyrosis, the ability to emit flame from their bodies. I may be able to correct this error, but I can't get near my equipment.
Intelligence. I'm shocked you didn't attempt this in a controlled environment first.
Your knowledge of experimental procedure surprises me. Indeed, I have skipped a step and directly modified an entire brood. Perhaps I was too hasty.
You think?
I was so certain it would work. To correct this mistake, I'll need to get to my terminal to modify the mutagen.
Isn't that what they use on the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles? What can I do to help? So, it's your mistake, Doc. You fix it.
Since you've offered, allow me to elaborate. My portable terminal is set up in the hatchery chamber near the Ant Queen. If I can reach it, I can continue to work on improving the mutagen.
If the Queen's your concern, why not deal with it directly? Why not just kill the queen and be done with it? So you want me to pop the queen, huh? If the queen's concerned, why not deal with it directly?
If she were harmed in any way, months of data would be lost. Your objective would be to eliminate what I call her quintet of nest guardians. Filthy little abominations.
Apparently it's the only one of this entire species of ant that he doesn't like. Just how will all this undo the mayhem you've caused? This will stop the fire ants. I hope that's everything. I've had enough of ants. I'm gonna be civil on with this guy because, you know, as an intelligent person myself, both in the game and I like to think in real life, I like scientists and I like people who, you know, try to fix things through the science, and I don't want to fuck up his data.
No,
that would
it
be
should
bad.
All wrap up rather nicely. I've rigged my equipment at my portable terminal to emit what I call an inhibitor pulse. Once I send this pulse, all of the remaining ants will lose their empathic link with the queen and frenzy, destroying each other in the process. So, that's all there is to it. What do you say?
Huh. Okay. Well, they're all gonna kill each other, who cares? If it'll stop the ants from burning down Grey Ditch, I'm in. I think they already did that. It's a hefty task, Doc. Looks like we're gonna have to call in the Justice Team. This is a hefty. I'm reading the same thing. Books aren't going to buy me new ammunition. You want help? Fork over some caps, Einstein. Let me get back to you on this. Is there a certain thing that, when prompted to respond, this is a hefty task, Doc, but I'm going to need serious incentive to sway the doctor into giving you his old lab coat and mutagenic bioenhancer. Works for me!
Yes, I suppose you're right. Science must learn to acquiesce to your standards in order to advance itself. I was merely going to offer up one of my mutagenic bioenhancers, but I suppose I could up the ante.
If you're already going to do that, then I really don't care.
My old lab coat. It served me well over the years, and you may find it useful for your own experiments.
Yeah, whatever, sure. Mutagenic bio.
I've managed to isolate some of the fire ant genes and distill them into human-safe genetic enhancers. I can inject you with one of these formulas, and you'll find yourself with either enhanced strength or enhanced perception.
I'll take that strength.
Not only that, but you'll be somewhat more resistant to fire. How marvelous.
Marvelous. Actually, I'll just go with whatever one I have lower. Anyway, if it'll stop the ants from burning down Greyditch, I'm in.
It will? How marvelous. Be careful, my friend. The Nest Guardians can be quite tenacious.
My work is done. You can go down there. What else can you tell me about these fire ants? What do you know about Brian Wilkes?
Far too curious. His incessant questioning would often come when I was the most absorbed with my calculations. He had no regard for the importance of my work.
You know, he probably distracted you to the point where fucking fucked up. Can't you take responsibility for his father's death? Don't you realize you've ruined his entire life? You should have at least told him you were alive. He thought he was alone. Let's go with that one.
I can't risk leaving this place. I have to continue monitoring the hatchery for any further mutations in the next brood. I have no time for children and their petty games. What do they know about the importance of my work?
It's not really a petty game. You killed his father indirectly. Can you take responsibility for his father's death?
All scientists take responsibility for their failures because it comes with the territory.
Well, thank you.
I will take this experimentation to completion without roosting on the moral high ground. If I allow emotions to enter the mix, all this time and energy spent will have been for nothing.
I honestly see where he's coming from. I'm not gonna keep driving that point home. There's no point. What else can you tell me about the fire ants? I don't need to know. About your experiments.
Oh my, yes. They're quite marvelous. There are many that say it can't be done, but I'll prove them wrong.
There it is. The book says something about this. Something isn't right. You shouldn't have gotten results like this so quickly.
Well, I may have used a few, the shortcuts, yes.
Really?
That the FEV works wonders when used under controlled circumstances. Apparently, I was wrong, but I know my mistake. I'm certain I can get it to work.
Why did I want to know that? Well, alright, yeah, it does add a little bit more experience just for having the conversation. What's the goal of your experiments? How exactly can I destroy the mutagen?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm pretty sure we got a pretty good layout of what's going on here.
So much to do.
You're right. Stop that! Jeez. Well, let's close this so you don't die too. Be nice. Can I touch it? Aww. Jerk. What do you got? I don't have any more questions. I want your stuff. But for some reason, I'm only allowed to take the stuff I don't want. Excuse me. Can't go a single fucking episode without. Okay. Anything that doesn't say it's stealing, I'm gonna take. Wrong box. No. It's fun to walk around with the hockey mask. fun to walk around with a hockey mask, you know, for funsies from time to time, but yeah, it won't protect your face. Alright. I wasn't sure if I was only reading, seeing one box or two. Whoop. 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 Alright. Alrighty. Now you can keep your extra pistol. Aww. Let me sleep in your bed. I saved your life. Alright. Well, we're gonna end it here with Dr. Lesko, and next we come back, we'll be going down there to fight evil ants. So thank you all so much for watching. Drive safely.
I suppose I could answer a few more questions.